Doxycycline is the most commonly used antibiotic for Lyme disease. It's a easy to take twice a day pill oral antibiotic. And the unique features of doxycycline are that it's an antibiotic that's actually effective for not just Lyme disease, but many of the tick-borne infections, such as anaplasmosis, ehrlichiosis, and Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Doxycycline shouldn't necessarily be used in children under the age of 8, but for adults, doxycycline would be our first-line therapy. Doxycycline is used in three major scenarios when a clinician is considering tick-borne diseases. The first scenario is when we have a firm diagnosis of Lyme disease or anaplasmosis or Rocky Mountain spotted fever. The second scenario is when we have a high-risk situation where it's a Lyme or tick-borne disease endemic region of the United States. It's the right season of the year. And so we know there's a high likelihood of a tick-borne infection, but we don't yet have a firm final diagnosis. This is called empiric therapy. And in this scenario, we often go to doxycycline when the risk of a tick-borne infection is high. The third scenario would be in life-threatening situations where we suspect a life-threatening infection like Rocky Mountain spotted fever. It's a unique antibiotic in its impact on bacteria and its ability to stop the growth of bacteria, but it's also unique in its impact on the human immune system and its ability to act as an anti-inflammatory. In order to improve the effectiveness of doxycycline, we want to make sure that all the pills are absorbed when they're ingested into the stomach and bowels. And the one potential inhibitor of absorption is calcium. So taking doxycycline is very important to try to minimize calcium intake, especially in the form of calcium vitamins or Tums or foods that are high in calcium, such as dairy products. And in general, we recommend not taking dairy products or milk or calcium vitamins within an hour or two before or after you take doxycycline. The impact of calcium on the absorption is mild, but may be as high as a 20% inhibition of absorption of the doxycycline medication. We recommend people try to take doxycycline on an empty stomach. In some people, however, this will cause stomach upset. And so if that happens, it is okay to take doxycycline with foods. Just again, avoid foods like dairy or yogurt that are high in calcium. The most common side effect of doxycycline is called esophagitis. That's irritation or ulceration of the food pipe, the esophagus that goes from the mouth to the stomach. Doxycycline is particularly irritating for the food pipe, the esophagus, and so we always want to make sure that the pills are completely washed down into your stomach. Always take doxycycline with a large glass of water, and then we advise not laying down for at least an hour after you take doxycycline. This will make sure that doxycycline gets down into the stomach and stays in the stomach. If doxycycline causes irritation or ulceration of the esophagus, it presents with symptoms of pain with swallowing or pain in the chest. That's an indication that there could be an ulcer forming, and that's a potentially serious complication of doxycycline. Again, we try to avoid that at all costs by taking doxy with a large glass of water and then not lying down afterwards. If you develop, however, pain in the esophagus or pain with swallowing in the chest while you're taking doxycycline, you should stop the medication and call your physician for advice. The second major side effect of doxycycline is sun sensitivity. Doxycycline causes an enhanced reaction to sun and an enhanced sunburn in some people. It doesn't happen in everyone, but when it happens, it's an unpleasant sunburn-like sensation. Some people describe it as almost a sense of a burning or like oil was poured on their skin. And people can get rashes from sun sensitivity and sunburn in unusual places. For instance, the back of the hand or the top of the feet when you're wearing sandals. People should be aware of this and take appropriate precautions, wear long sleeve shirts and cover up as much skin as is practical and possible. And then you use a very high SPF containing sunscreen on areas of your skin that you can't cover up. For instance, the face, the nose, the ears, the top of the hands. There are rare serious side effects from doxycycline. As in any antibiotic, you can get an true allergic reaction to doxycycline, and the risk factors for this to be aware of is the development of a generalized skin rash, not one that is just in sun exposed areas, but a generalized rash, and especially any rash that's accompanied by systemic symptoms such as a new fever or headache or other signs of a generalized drug reaction, those would be indications to stop the drug and call your physician. Another very rare, uncommon side effect of doxycycline is the development of severe headaches. This is a rare condition called pseudotumor cerebri. These are headaches that may be accompanied by visual loss or blindness and extreme nausea and vomiting. And this is a serious, fortunately rare, but very serious side effect that, again, severe headache accompanied by visual changes should prompt stopping the doxycycline and contacting your physician immediately. Doxycycline is usually prescribed between 14 and 21 days of therapy. It's a twice-a-day pill antibiotic, so it should be spaced apart approximately 12 hours. Of course, as with all antibiotics, care should be taken not to miss doses. If a dose is missed and it's only with a few hours off, it's okay to take the doxycycline a few hours late. If a complete dose is missed, then the advice would be to then just pick up the next dose at the 12-hour interval that comes next. As in all antibiotics, you should complete the entire prescription of doxycycline. Don't stop the doxycycline just because you're feeling better. Complete the entire course of therapy and then follow up with your physician about your response to the therapy.